So you hear they're having a welcome home Kellie Harper day. What's your thoughts about that? Then you finally get in here tonight, and I know it had to have been just overwhelming.
Well, it was. First of all, this is a great place to grow up, great place to live, great people here. And I'd heard they were wanting to try to do something really special, and they did. They had a home run, and it was really neat for me to see the combination of efforts from the University of Tennessee, as well as the folks here in White County, and it was really a memorable evening.
You know, you were holding it together, but then when they gave you the key to the city, it looked like you got a little emotional there.
You know, the key to the city, that's kind of neat, you know, and the story of him saying he's never done that, and then the court, being on the court at the elementary school that's really special, and because I know how big of a deal that is here. You know, the elementary school athletic programs here in White County are really good. And that's where I got my start, at Findlay Elementary, so it's really cool.
That is the elementary school you attended?
Yes, I attended Findlay Elementary.
And to see the support of the community like this, and you're looking out and seeing all those smiling faces in the stands, what's going through your mind up there?
Well, the first thing is, you know, half the folks in there didn't see me play basketball here. You know, they're young, they didn't see, so they're just going by what they've heard and what they've read or what they've been told. So, I think that the community has been wonderful about embracing me throughout my career, whether I was playing or coaching, regardless of where that was, they kept tabs on me. I mean, they kept up with me, and it's really neat to see them be able to now, they've always loved Tennessee, and now to be able to do that with me, one of their own, it's just really special.
Coach, you ever think all that time spending practicing jumpers in the gym would lead you back to this moment?
No, I did not. I think for me, you know, I was always in the moment and working on my game, but I never thought big picture. I never thought, hey, if I keep making these jumpers, maybe I could go to the University of Tennessee and then swirl it around and then come back there as the coach. No, not in my wildest dreams growing up. But, when that did become a dream and a goal, it's pretty amazing.
How often have you been able to make it to Sparta since you've got this job?
In the last couple of months, I've actually had to come over here about 3 or 4 times because I've needed to go out of town recruiting and I needed someone to watch the kids. So I drove them here to Sparta for the weekend. So I've actually been back a few times, just haven't been able to stay very long.
How much of a difference does that make to have that support this close now?
Well, I think it's a really special and unique situation. When you're in my profession, if you want to succeed and be able to be the best you can be, you've got to be willing to move. You've got to be willing to relocate and to be able to be in this profession and to go home, one, to your alma mater, and two, to be in as close as you can at that level to your hometown. It's special.
You mentioned you've had 3 workouts so far. What's been your impressions of the group, in particular the freshmen?
Yeah, I think they've been very willing. I keep saying that about our team. They've been very eager. And, we have some good athleticism, good size. So right now the freshmen are still trying to figure out how to get from class to practice. They've done a great job, though. I've been really, really proud of our youngsters as well as our returners.
I know you spoke a little bit about following your dreams in your speech. Why do you think that's so impactful for all the little girls and little boys who are here today?
Well, I think sometimes you look around and you need something to show you what you can do. And if you're just thinking, I'm from a small town, I can't do anything outside of here, they're wrong. And I just want them to know this is a great place to grow up, and it can provide a platform for you to move on to whatever your dream is, if it's here or if it's somewhere else.
During that Q&A session afterward, were you surprised at all that someone asked you about the starting point guard situation so early? Does that passion surprise you?
Well, initially it surprised me, and then I remembered, oh yes, Tennessee. So our people here are very well educated. They love basketball. They understand it, and probably want to know if we're working on post moves. They probably want to know if we're working on rebounding. But I think that's just the fans we're dealing with.
Has any of this really truly sunk in for you yet, that you are in the position you're in?
You know, occasionally there will be a moment that it will, but for the most part, we're just going from task to task, just trying to get things done. So you just don't have a time to sit back and just take it all in. And I don't know I don't know that that's a good thing or a bad thing right now. You know, you walk by Pat's picture daily, and you get excited about that daily, but then you're on to something else. You're on to your next task. We've just been really busy, which is a good thing. But it's a big deal.
I apologize. As you're out there on the road, how is Tennessee being received, and how is it different to be recruiting, you know, as a Tennessee coach?
Right. Well, it's very different. I think you say you're from the University of Tennessee, and ears perk up. So what we have to do is be able to then now sell them on our vision. And I think we've been received positively. That doesn't mean everyone has had interest to follow through with us, but we've been received positively early. And I think right now if we can have that reception with our coaches that we're recruiting players of, whether that's high school or summer coaches, if they can feel that, that's going to help us down the road as we build relationships with these young players.
The conference schedule came out yesterday. A lot of traditional powers, tough opponents. What do you think about that? Having that challenge, you know, right out of the gates in year one.
Well, we definitely have a challenging top end there, and I think for us, we're gonna talk to our team about that. I think they expect that. We're gonna talk to our recruits about that. You know, we want to play good teams. We want to play a good schedule. So, you come to the University of Tennessee, you want to compete, and you want to compete against the best.
Kellie, what was the backstory there behind the poem? Do you know who was that woman?
The lady that read the poem is my aunt. It's my mom's sister, Sharon Haston. She writes poetry quite a bit, and I did not know she was going to come up and read her poem to me.
Kellie, you played under one of the greatest of all time, Pat Summitt, and she has definitely left her legacy on you and molded you and shaped you. What do you want your legacy to be as you enter this next season?
Wow, that's a big question. You know, I want people to know that we're going to do things the right way. We're going to work really hard, but we're going to enjoy it. We're going to do it with smiles on our faces. You know, I want our players to be having the absolute time of their lives out there. And I want our staff to be doing the same thing. I love what I do, and I want it to show.
Okay, when you left as a player back in 1999, Fulmer was still coaching. What's it been like to work with him as an athletic director now?
Well, I think for me, I still call him Coach Fulmer. You know, that's how I see him. That's how I view him. But he's been really supportive and very understanding of the position. And, you know, I'm just excited about continuing that relationship.